Hey brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I'm trying to make it. This is like my fourth video because I said I would. The other day when I was praying, I saw this vision of an angel, and he was, he had like these bow and arrows, and he was like giving it to me. And then I saw there was like an open heaven, and then I had a dream that night, brothers and sisters, and it's connected, like the dream I had the other day about the flood. This is a very similar thing. It's the same meaning. There's a personal meaning and a meaning for the church. So anyway, I had this dream, and in this dream I went into a house. The Lord had provided me with a house, a home for my family. All right. Well, when I got in there and I was looking around the house, I was suddenly unable to speak. There was an evil presence in the house, and I was unable to speak. And my wife told me, well, somebody said that there might be some kind of a, they can see a demon in this mirror in the bathroom. And then the text that the Lord gave me for that is this, Paul says we look through a glass darkly in the King James. With glass, he's talking about it's like a mirror. So we look through there darkly. It's seeing revelation. So anyway, I looked in the mirror and I saw something that someone who looked just like Jesus, but there was something wrong. And I knew immediately that this was not the Christ, but the Antichrist. And then he was trying to make himself look good. And then when he saw that I knew who he was, he discerned it, or saw it in my face, he immediately turned evil. And he had a white, white, white face, like a vampire, like you put white cream or cold cream on your face. And his hair was jet black and dirty looking and scroungy. As a matter of fact, it looked a lot like the picture, the famous portrait you might see of Albert Pike. His hair was like that, and he was raggedy looking. He was thin though, but he was really raggedy and dirty looking, scroungy looking. Very jet black beard. It was filthy, and hair, long hair, like Jesus, but dirty, and black hair and a white, really pale white skin, like a vampire or something. And I couldn't speak. And so I kept trying to give sign language to my wife to get my wife to begin to rebuke him. And then my wife rebuked him, and then he was just laughing. But as my wife was rebuking him, then I got my voice back. And then I was able to rebuke him also, and then he was gone. And I just want to stop right there and say that it's just like the other dream I had about the floods. I had sent my wife to do something. She was not there with me. So a personal message for me is, get your wife more involved in the ministry. This is the same dream about the dream I had about the flood, but a different way of looking at it and a whole other part of it. The flood coming. This is a whole different way of seeing it. And so then, brothers and sisters, as soon as I was able to rebuke him, and then boom, then in the mirror I saw this bright light, brothers and sisters. I mean a mega bright light. And I looked in the mirror, and this time I saw a guy wearing all white with a white beard, but it was trimmed really short. I mean just like so neatly trimmed. It looked so good and neat, and he had on a white hat. And also, I was telling my wife, it looked like Mario. I mean, his clothes. He was wearing an outfit kind of like what Mario wears, but it was all white. His beard was white. His skin was like rosy pink. And he was looking at me. And then I was like, what is this? And then, and I could hear in my mind from him, I'm a holy angel, sent from the Lord God Almighty, from the Lord Jesus Christ. And then, and I knew I could feel the Holy Spirit. I could see the shine kind of glory. Oh, yeah. All those little particular people. The word Shekinah glory that people use, the word Shekinah is not in the Bible. Okay, the glory of God. I just want to say that. Because, it's got out on the internet that the word Shekinah is not in the Bible. Okay, it's an expression. I don't know why people use that expression, but the word Shekinah is not in the Bible. The glory of God. Okay. So anyway, all those people that major in the minors, people going to hell, millions of people going to hell, and they're worried about this kind of a thing. It's really sad. And they think, wait till Judgment Day. It's going to be something on Judgment Day with that kind of stuff, brothers and sisters. Anyway, so there was this holy angel looking at me and grinning at me. And then I could look in the mirror, and then he was turning the mirror. Like he was holding the mirror on one side, and I was holding the mirror on the other side. And I was turning. And as we turned the mirror, brothers and sisters, I could see behind him. As he was turning the mirror, like he was turning around in a circle. Like he was turning around in a circle. And then I could see everything behind him through the mirror. So it's talking about prophecy. As soon as I rebuke the enemy and get him out of my life, my wife will help me get the the enemy away from me, attack from the enemy, out of my home, out of my life, then I could see clearly. So it's talking about more revelation, more prophecy, more understanding from God. Okay, but in that mirror, what I could see, brothers and sisters, which is really cool, I saw all these groups of angels. And these groups of angels, and nothing about the Antichrist, he had a light glowing on him like a dim candlelight. Like a candlelight. And then when the light from the Lord came, the bright glory of God, not the Shekinah glory, the word Shekinah, but the glory of God, known to people as the Shekinah glory, there was that bright light. It was a million times like the more than the sun, right? So bright white light, whereas this was a dim, like a red or orange flame that the Antichrist had. So it's a difference between the dim light of the torch bearer, like the Statue of Liberty. Lucifer is the luminous one, the light bearer, but this is the light of God. So I saw these groups of angels sitting around like in groups of four. And it was all on this mountainside, like where the Sermon on the Mount was or something, what you'd imagine the Sermon on the Mount. You know, it was all these rocky hills looking thing. The mountain of God. And these angels were sitting in groups of four, brothers and sisters. But they had like a light in the middle of them, like a campfire, but it was a white, bright light, not the light like the Antichrist, or like if you made a campfire, it's going to be orange. This was like the glory of God color, but it was like a little campfire. And they were sitting around. And then I heard like some of the angels started cheering and carrying on one group. They were cheering and carrying on and saying, hey. And they were talking to Abraham and said, oh, do you remember when you did this and that? We were there with you and it was really great. And, you know, and God used you and us together to do ABC. They were talking to Abraham. And then another group, I could hear them at the same time. There was another group talking to Moses and they were cheering. And each group had someone from the Bible they were assigned to. And then they were talking to them. Hey, remember like when you passed the burning bush and we were there, it was really cool. And then we confounded Pharaoh. And they were talking to Moses and cheering. And they were so happy and rejoicing with Moses about what God had done through them and Moses together. And so the point is, brothers and sisters, we have angels with us, what you're assigned to do by God. And then for me personally, of course, God has those angels with me to do the ministry. If you have a ministry, you know, you got your guardian angel. The Bible says we have angels that guard over us, Psalm 91. And then the Bible says in Hebrews that there are ministering spirits assigned to those who are being saved. So we have spirits that minister to us, angels. But then, if you're in the ministry like myself, and like say God uses you in healing ministry, they say there's angels of healing, angels of prophecy, angels of revival, breakthrough angels, angels of praise and worship, all the angels of different assignments. You know, all those things we don't really know. Unless the Lord reveals them to us, all the details of how that works. But there's multitudes of millions of angels, and they're doing something. You know, I mentioned this before. Lots of times people say, you know, the Holy Spirit is doing this, the Holy Spirit's doing that. Of course, God is doing everything, right? But lots of times, you know, it's an angel that we can feel. We can't see it, but we feel an angel going and someone gets healed, and we say, oh, it's the Holy Spirit. When actually, it's probably an angel coming from God. We just can't see it. And so, you know, for those who are scared to death to talk about angels, God's got millions of them. And they must be doing something. Why would God have millions of angels if they weren't doing anything? They're doing something. If God was literally physically guarding us, which, you know, with His Holy Spirit, why would we need guardian angels? Of course, why does He need watcher angels? All of those things that God has, God is executing His word through them and then through us. And then His Spirit is directing all that. How all that works, you know, we can only speculate, and God's giving us a little bit here, a little bit there, clues from the Word. We don't know how all that operates. Like as an example, in the book of Daniel, when Gabriel came to Daniel, after Daniel had fasted 21 days, he said, you know, behold, you know, you are highly favored of God or loved of God. I tried to, you know, I was sent the first day, but the prince of Persia withstood me until your prince, the Archangel Michael, you know, came and helped me get loose so I could come give you this prophecy. You know, so there's things going on in the heavens that we don't know, we can't see, we don't understand, we only have bits and pieces, but they're real, brothers and sisters. And the holy angels are working with us to do God's will. So for me personally, God is, you know, showing me that He's got a team of angels to work with me for the ministry. And then for all of you guys, if you're not in the ministry, of course we have angels to work with us to guard us, to protect us in our lives with our families, and also help us to, if we do something for the Lord, evangelism, try to pray for somebody and all that, the Lord sends angels to help us do that. So it's not about worshiping angels and all that stuff. The Bible tells us not to worship angels. But we should be aware that there are spiritual partners in the battle. They're with us. If those angels wasn't with us, I guess demons would attack us and kill us if they could. They're stopping them from doing that. So we should thank the Lord for the angels he gave us. We should thank the Lord and ask the Lord, as he said in his word. He gives ministering spirits to those who are being saved. Ask the Lord, Lord, send more of your ministering spirits with me, that I can do more for you in Jesus' name. Send the ministering spirits ahead of me, Lord, and guide and direct me into, you know, running into somebody I could evangelize, pray with, things like that. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless. I want to go more, but I got to cut it off because bath time has gone over time. God bless.